Good morning, Congressman. How are you?
Well, good morning, Bill. How are you?
I'm good. I have to ask you, first of all, I want to thank you because all the work you're doing on opioid abuse and recovery and helping a lot of people that need it, you've done a great job with that. So thank you for what you've done in Washington on our behalf.
Well, it's a very sad need, but it is a desperate need, and I will keep working at that.
So here's a question for you, and I'm always tight on time in the mornings, but I want to ask you about this visa, this immigration lottery that we have. I'll be very straight with you. I didn't even realize this program existed until this attack in New York. Do you agree that it really is time for us to visit this kind of program and start to look at the world through the lens of we have to be vigilant and better prepared for terrorism?
I have been aware of this lottery, and I think it's really a dumb way to do immigration policy. We need to attract and keep the best and the brightest on the one hand, and we also need just hardworking people that believe in American values and want to be here to do the things that this country needs done. And there's a lot of different people in those two groups, but to just pick people by dumb luck, to me, makes no sense at all. People get upset when the president talks about extreme vetting. We've had extreme carelessness for a long time when it comes to how people get in this country. And it of course, it needs to be addressed. We have to get much better at figuring out who do we need? What kind of skilled workers do we need in this economy? And I want to have a robust immigration policy, but we live in a world that's going to hell in a handbasket, and we better wake up and do what's necessary to protect ourselves while we have people come in.
Are you somewhat concerned by the dismissive comments on by Ambassador Phil Murphy? I mean, the guy called him a jerk. Like, it just seemed to be an absurd way to characterize what happened. I mean, eight people are dead.
Well, look, this is not even new. His philosophy is let's go by ideology rather than reality. His desire to make New Jersey into a sanctuary state, nobody's ascribing that to him. I've heard him say it with his own words. And these are the same people that think the federal government should control everything except suddenly immigration policy. Now he wants states, even towns, to decide which immigration policies they'll enforce and how they'll practice immigration.
Yeah.
It's not only dangerous, it is so intellectually bankrupt. The Constitution is crystal clear. Congress is responsible for immigration policy, and he just wants to suspend that and have towns, cities, states decide what they'll do with immigrants. It's a really dangerous policy, and I read the polls, Bill, just like you do, and they say that he's got an edge. I surely hope voters get out to the polls and don't elect somebody who's going to make life more dangerous in New Jersey and in the country.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Tom. I appreciate that common sense. I think you are truly a leader with courage and vision. And, obviously we'll keep talking because the next thing that's going to happen is we're going to have a midterm election in 2018. And it's going to be very, very important to really drill down into the issues. And to me, it's about who best represents our interests in Washington, regardless of who wins on Tuesday. These issues are going to be there. They're front and center. And I'll tell you, whether it's opioids or terrorism, we are literally talking about life and death issues in this country. And we need some serious, mature people to make these decisions.